Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture series on microcontroller lab. In the previous lab session we had looked into hexadecimal up counter and as well as hexadecimal down counter. In today's session we shall look into decimal up counter and then decimal down counter. That means here actually basically we will be looking into a decimal counter which counts from 0 to 99. Okay. So it is not going to count more than 99, so it is going to count from 0 to 99. So here what is the logic behind this thing is that in the hexadecimal counter what we had loaded is that since we are going to count from 00 to 99, right? So this is going to count from 00 to 99. So what actually we had done, so we have made our accumulator to be what? We have loaded to this accumulator, we had loaded the initial value 00 hexa. From this, in order to do the up count, we had used what? We had used increment operator, right? So using increment instruction, we had loaded with A to 00, so it was counting from 00 to FF hexa and we had kept in a loop, right? So what actually happens, suppose if I want to do if I want to perform decimal increments, then this particular increment operation is not going to be useful. Okay, why? In the sense why? Because see, now after if I since my a microcontroller is going to work in terms of hexadecimal, what is going to happen is that it is going to count from 0 to 9. This is going to be a proper. After 9, it is going to increment in terms of what? It is going to increment in terms of A, B, C, till where? Till it is going to be F. After that, it is going to increment in terms of 10 to 1F. So this is all what this whole this thing is in terms of hexadecimal, but I want my this thing to be what? I want from after 9, I want my this thing to be what? It is should be, it is would be 10, and then after 10 it is should be 11, and then after that it should be 12. So this type of increment I needed. So when you want this particular type of increment, this increment of instruction what we are having, it is not going to work out, since this is it is going to increment in terms of hexadecimal. So we need to find an alternative method where we can use where we can come up with this type of increment. So how actually this is being done is that, so what actually we are going to do, since I am going to count from 0 to 99, okay, and in order to make in terms of a binary coded decimal, what we are having, let me load my accumulator with 00 hexa. Let me load that with 00 hexa itself. After that, let me call my delay program. Okay, so once delay is being done, because why this delay is being called, because my microcontroller, it is going to be working in terms of higher frequency. When you are using higher frequency, we need to add delay so that we can where so that our eyes can find out the increment operation, whether it is going properly or not. Okay, so after delay what I'll be doing, I'll add, okay, what I'm going to do, since it is it should be incremented with one value, so I'll be adding A with what I'm going to add with 1. Okay, so for that I'll be using my immediate addressing mode, so 01 hexa I will do. So after this, why I am using this increment operator? Okay, even increment operator does the same thing, but why I am using this add operation is that this decimal adjustment what we are having, okay, this particular thing what we are having, this is going to work only when you are done with addition operation. After addition operation only I can use this decimal adjustment operator. This particular decimal adjustment operator we had seen in module 3, okay, in arithmetic operations we had seen how actually this decimal adjustment is going to work. Okay, so in order to make sure that my these things are in terms of binary coded decimal, so I'll be using this decimal adjustment operator. After that, what I'll be doing, again I'll be coming back to this particular delay program. So I'll be keeping it in a loop so that this A is going to increment from 00 to 99 hexa. So let us look into how actually we can write the program. So let us look into the program over here. So let me call, start off with 00 hexa. Okay, so as I need to move A with the 00 hexa, so I'll write move A comma hash 00 hexa. So we have given the any we have loaded the initial value with 00 hexa. Now what we need to do, I need to call delay. So since this is a loop, so let me name this loop as execute. Okay, so after in execute loop I need to call delay. Since this is a short call, so I'll be using absolute call, and then I'll name that target as delay. Okay, so here we have call delay. After calling delay, what I should perform, I should perform this addition operation. So add a comma hash 01 hexa I'll give. So I have added with the 01 hexa. Now I to have to adjust it into using decimal adjustment. So I'll call this DA and then I'll give A. So decimal adjustment I have done. So now what I should do, jump if not equal to 0, where it should go, it should come back to execute. Okay, so it should come back to execute. After this I need to stop this, I need to terminate. So I'll be using sjump dollar. Okay, so this is all regarding the increment operation, but I need to write down the program for even delay as well. So let me write here delay. Okay, since I have named there as delay, so let me call it as delay itself. Here also let me load my R0 with hash 030 hexa. As we had seen why I have used 030, so let me call this back one, and then let me load with R1 with hash 0FF hexa, and then let me give this as back two, and then let me load move R2 comma hash 0FF hexa. So these are the values which we need to load in order to write down the, in order to increase the delay and then decrement the delay. So we'll be using DJNZ. So I'll be using R2, where it should be, it should be in here also, here only. Then what I will do, I'll decrement my R1. After R1, where it should come, it should come to back 2. So after this I'm going to decrement R0, and then it should come back to where it should come back to back 1. Okay, so this is how it is being done, and then once after this it should come back to my main program. So I'll be using return, and then after this is going to be end. So here we have done with this. Okay, so let me compile this. Okay, let me build it. Okay, so here you can observe zero errors and zero warnings. In order to build, what you will be using, you will be using F7, and then I should go to debug mode. Either you can go here debug and then start debug. Here you can see that I can use a shortcut, that is control F5. Okay, so let me get into debug mode. So let me close this a little bit. Okay, so here you can observe, here I have already opened this watch window. So you can see the initial value is being 99 over here. Now if I press run, you can observe it is being decremented to in terms of decimal number, as you can see. So after 29 it is going to 30, 31, 37, 40, 41, 44, 46, 47, 50. So you can observe this particular thing. Okay, so here you can observe the increment operation of the decimal up counter. Okay, so this is how up counter decimal up counter is being done. So now let us look into how actually we can perform decrement operator. Okay, so when decrement operation, if you want to do decrement operation, again what is the problem is that again we are having a problem over here. So what might be the problem? So I need to decrement from 99. So okay, let me take it in terms of, so I need it to be decremented in terms of 99 comma 98 and then comma 97, 96. This is the format I should follow, right? So this is not going to happen if I use what? If I use decrement operator. So decrement operator, again what it will do, so here what happens is that let me take a scenario over here. If I have 90, so let me take by using decrement operator from 99 we have reached what? We have reached 90. Now if I use again decrement, then what will happen is that it does not come back to 89, it will go back to 8F, because this is in terms of hexadecimal format. Okay, so this is the scenario if I use decrement operator, and this scenario is going to be same for even our subtraction operator as well, right? So even if I use subtract sub a comma hash 01 hex, if I do, even this will result in the same problem. So this particular what we are having, it is not going to work. So what I can do is that in order to perform this operation, right, so I want this thing to be in terms, I want to use this particular operator, that is my decimal adjustment. So this I need to do, but this is going to work only if I perform add, right? So what I can do is that let me load A with the initial value 99 hexa. Okay, for this 99 hexa, what I'll be doing, I'll be adding the 99 hexa with what? Again, I'll be adding 99 hexa. So hash 99 hexa I'll do. So this what happens is that now let us see in terms of decimal only over here how actually this is going to work. So suppose if I have 99 over here, okay, so now if I add 99 to this, what will happen? 9 plus 9, it is going to be 8, 18. So here 8, 1 carry, so 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 9, it is going to be 19, right? So this is going to be 19. So this particular this thing will be discarded. I'll be ending up with what? 98. Now if I add again 99 to this particular value 98, what is going to happen? 9 plus 8, it is going to be 17. Okay, and then 9 plus 1, 10, and then 9, it is going to be 19. I'll discard this value 1. Okay, so I'll be ending up with what? 97. Again, if I add 99 to this, so I'll be ending up with what? 96. So after decimal adjustment, I can get the no normal values, which are like this: 99, 98, 97, 96, something like this. So that is why, since I need to adjust my decimal value, that is DA, decimal adjustment, but this decimal adjustment is totally dependent on this add operator. That is why I'll be adding 99 to my accumulator value. Okay, so this is how we are going to perform what we are going to perform our decimal down counter operator. So as we know, let us do what and all changes I can perform is that let me load my A with what? I should load with 99 hexa. Okay, so I need to add what? Instead of 01 hexa, I need to add 99 hexa, and then decimal adjustment, and the delay program remains same. So this is how the this is the only difference what we can have in terms of decimal down counter. So let me rebuild. So here zero errors and zero warnings, and let me go back to in terms of evaluation mode. Now here you can observe this particular watch window over here. Let me run this program. See, here you can observe. Now it has started in terms of decrementing down counter. This is how it is being done. Here you can observe the values over here in this particular point, right? So it is getting decremented every time. So this is how the decimal down counter is being done. Okay, so in the next lecture we shall look into the lab experiment number 4. Okay, so those are logical operations that we are going to see in the next lecture.